لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله وسلم عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما وأصلح لنا شأننا كله ولا تكلنا إلى أنفسنا طرفة عين أما بعد إن شاء الله تعالى At this blessed time of ours, I hope bi-idhnillahi al-kareem to extract some benefits from a hadith narrated in the two most authentic books, Sahih al-Bukhari and Sahih Muslim. Al-Imam al-Iraqi, he said in his Alfiyah, وَأَوَّلُ مَنْ صَنَّفَ فِي الصَّحِيحِ مُحَمَّدٌ وَخُصَّ بِالتَّرْجِيحِ ومسلم بعد وبعد الغرب مع أبي علي فضلوا ذا لو نفع ولم يعماه ولكن قلما إن دبن الأخرم منه قد فاتهما. So the first person who authored in the most authentic book is who? الإمام البخاري رحمه الله. And the second person who authored in the most authentic book after الإمام البخاري is Al-Imam Muslim rahimahullah. They both narrated a hadith from the noble companion Muawiyah radiyallahu ta'ala anhu that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam he said مَنْ يُرِدِ اللَّهُ بِهِ خَيْرًا يُفَقِّهُ فِي الدِّينِ Anyone who Allah wants for them good, He makes them understand the religion. This hadith is great. It is great, brothers. And this hadith, it requires and it needs from us أن نتأمله, that we observe it and we look at it. Because this hadith holds great affairs in it. فَإِنَّهُ عَظِيمُ الشَّأْنِ جَلِيلُ الْقَدْرِ Its status is very great. And the benefits that are in it are immense. كَبِيرُ الْأَهْمِيَّةِ Importance is also big. This hadith urges each and every one of us towards knowledge and studying, understanding the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it also mentions the virtue of the one who treads on the path of seeking knowledge. So inshallah ta'ala, we're going to extract some benefits from this hadith, inshallah ta'ala. Al-fa'idat al-ula, the first benefit. Every matter is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's nothing that takes place in this world, in this universe, illa ma aradahu Allah, except that which Allah wills. The only thing that will happen in this world is that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills. Virtue and nobility and blessings are all in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He blesses who He wills, He virtues who He wills, He bestows His blessing onto who He wills. And Allah gives the ability to whoever He wills. As He says in the Quran, وَمَا تَوْفِيقِي إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ تَوَكَّلْتُ وَإِلَيْهِ أُنِيبُ My ability cannot occur except through Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. عَلَيْهِ تَوَكَّلْتُ On Him I rely and I trust. وَإِلَيْهِ أُنِيبُ And to Him I will turn back to. So the first benefit that we take is all matters are in Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's hands. Allah controls it. And this is an important aqeedah related matter. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala He says in the Quran, وَعَلَّمَكَ مَا لَمْ تَكُنْ تَعْلَمْ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala He taught you that which you did not know. وَكَانَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكَ عَظِيمًا And the virtue over your Lord is great. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, Ar-Rahman allama al-Qur'an. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful, He is the one who taught, He is the one allama al-Qur'an, who taught us the Qur'an. So the knowledge that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He gives to somebody is an ability. It's a favor. That's what Allah said in the ayah that I mentioned before, وَعَلَّمَكَ مَا لَمْ تَكُنْ تَعْلَمْ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He taught you that which He didn't know. Then look what He said after that, وَكَانَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكَ عَظِيمًا. And the virtue of Allah on you is very great. Second benefit that we take from this hadith is أَهْمِيَةُ التَّوَكُّلُ, the importance on relying on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The importance on relying on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seeking help from Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in the hadith, he said, إِحْرِصْ عَلَى مَا يَنْفَعُكْ, strive to that which is going to benefit you. وَاسْتَعِمْ بِاللَّهِ, and seek help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلِذَلِكَ the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to Mu'adh, إِنِّي لَأُحِبُّكَ يَا مُعَادْ. The Prophet said to Mu'adh, verily Mu'adh, I love you. لَا تَدْعَنَّ دُبْرَ كُلِّ صَلَاةٍ, don't leave off after every prayer at the ending of it. أن تقول, to say, اللهم أو الله, أعني, aid me and support me. على ذكرك, in your remembrance. وشكرك, and expressing gratitude to you, O Allah. Give me the ability to do that. وحسن عبادتك, and to perfect worship to you, O Allah. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, after telling Mu'adh that he loves him, this is what the Prophet told him to come with. So the student of knowledge, the one who wants to seek knowledge, the one who wants to learn the religion of Allah, he is what? Bihajah. He's in great need of, when seeking knowledge, ila ma'unatillah. He's in great need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's help. He also is in need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's support. So that's the second benefit that we take from this hadith. And if Allah diverts you subhanahu wa ta'ala from aiding you and supporting you, and He doesn't give any of that to you, then you truly are not going to achieve anything. And you're not going to gain anything. The third benefit that we take from this hadith is أَهْمِيَةُ الدُّعَاء, the importance of dua, the importance of supplication, calling unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For who lakin? For every Muslim, and especially the student of knowledge. The student of knowledge has to have al-lujoo da'im, consistently turning back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Since the matters are all in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's hands, he always has to turn to Allah. As the poet said, وَالْعِلْمُ يَدْخُلُ قَلْبَ كُلِّ مُوَفَّقٍ مِنْ غَيْرِ بَوَّابٍ وَلَا اسْتِئْذَانِ وَيَرُدُّهُ الْمَحْرُومُ مِنْ خِذْلَانِهِ لَا تُشْقِنَ اللَّهُمَّ بِالْحِرْمَانِ. Knowledge enters everyone's heart. Everyone can absorb knowledge. But there can be obstacles that are placed in front of you that will not allow you to attain that knowledge. So if the person is turning to Allah excessively and is always asking of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him, he will give him what he wants. وَلِذَلِكَ مُطَرِّف Ibn Shakir rahimahullah, he said something very powerful. مُطَرِّف Ibn Abdullah al-Shakir هو من أحد التابعين, he's from one of the students of the companions. He said, تَأَمَّلْتُ الْخَيْرِ, he said, I observed good. I looked at what is good and the good that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed. And he said, فَرَأَيْتُ الْخَيْرَ, and I saw that the khayr is a lot. Salah is khayr, zakat is khayr, sawm is khayr, hajj. I saw that khayr is too much. And I realized all of it is in whose hands? وَوَجَدْتُ أَنَّ ذَلِكَ, and then I found that all of that khayr is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَأَيْقَنْتُ, I became upon conviction, unwavering conviction, أَنَّ الدُّعَاءَ, that the dua is مِفْتَاحُ كُلَّ خَيْرٍ, that the dua is the key to every good. That's what I came to know. That all of acts of obedience Allah commands us to do is all khayr. And all of that khayr is in whose hands? Allah. So I realized the key to all of the khayr is to what? To supplicate. Because you can't pray if Allah doesn't give you the ability to. وَلِذَلِكَ the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as Abu Dawood, Imam Tirmidhi and others narrated in Hadith Umm Salama رضي الله تعالى عنها, That she said that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam كان إذا أصبح, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the morning when he would pray his Fajr prayer, he would supplicate to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, and he would open his day by saying, Allahumma inni as'aluka, O Allah, I ask you, ilman nafi'an, beneficial knowledge. I ask you for beneficial knowledge. Wa rizqan tayyiban, and I ask you for good provision. Wa amalan mutaqabbalan, and I ask of you, O Allah, an accepted deed. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to start his day with these three things. And each and every one of those three things, they deserve to be made a lecture alone, because they're very comprehensive. It encompasses the prosperity and the good and the success a person is trying to gain and attain, and is trying to accumulate and accomplish in this world. These three du'a summarizes it. And if Allah doesn't give a person that in their day-to-day life, علما نافعا ورزقا طيبا وعملا متقبلا, then that person will not receive good. So what was the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam he's doing? It was that he used to start his day with this dua. ولذلك أمنا أم سلمة, she was said that كان رسول الله, and the word كان in the Arabic language, it shows that istimrar wa dawam, consistency and continuation. That this was the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's daydana, his doings. He would always make this dua. He would always say this every morning. So the talib ilm, the student of knowledge, his characteristics is what? Ad-du'a wal-luju' ad-da'im, that he's consistently turning back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he's asking of him. Al-fa'idatu al-rabi'a, the fourth benefit that we take from the hadith. The fourth benefit that we take from the hadith is a person treading on the path of knowledge, and them having love for knowledge, and them running towards knowledge is a sign from the signs of khair and good. If you see yourself, whenever you're told about a circle of knowledge, or you're told about a lecture is going to take place, and you're so happy and excited and you're running towards it, then this is a what? It is min amarat al-khayr, the signs of good. And it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has chosen you to be a person of good. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, مَنْ يُرِدِ اللَّهُ بِهِ خَيْرًا يُفَقِّهُ فِي الدِّينِ, whoever Allah wants good for. وَلِذَلِكَ the Arabs, they say the word khayr, it was اسم تفضيل على وزن أفعل. خير comes in the form of أفعل, like in the alif was dropped and it was not used. The reason why it was dropped is شدة التكرار, the word خير is used a lot, so they got rid of the alif, they don't use it. So ولذلك when you say خير you mean أخير, you mean the best. So whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants good for them, the best of affairs, he makes them understand the religion. The fifth benefit that we take from the hadith is, the hadith has a mantuq and it has a mafhum. A mantuq means a direct understanding that is taken from the hadith, and a mafhum is a reverse understanding. The reverse understanding is that al-insiraf al-nafs, the person's nafs leaving off knowledge and leaving off the circles of khayr, it's an actual indication that this person, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, has not wanted good for them. ولذلك the ulama, the scholars, when they look at the nusus al-wahyayn, the kitab and the sunnah, and the way that they extract rulings from it, they do it through two main ways. One of the dalala is called, in which they take the Quran from, is the direct instruction that the verse is given, or the instruction that the hadith is given. So if I say in this sitting, for example, Mahbub, you're good. The direct statement that can be taken from it is that I have praised Brother Mahbub. But the reverse that can be understood from it is that the rest are not good. That is the reverse understanding of my statement. So the hadith has a mantuq and it also has a mafhum, which is mafhum al-mukhalafa. That if you don't have love for seeking knowledge and you don't want to come to the circles of knowledge, then it shows and it indicates that you're not a person who's what? Who Allah wants good for. وَلِذَلِكَ this used to worry the pious predecessors. سَلَفُ هَذِي أُمَّةِ This used to worry them. And so they were those who loved circles of knowledge and they would hasten to it. The sixth benefit that we take from this hadith is the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam where he said, يُفَقِّهُ فِي الدِّينِ يَتَنَاوَلُ الْعُلُومُ الشَّرْعِي It encompasses all of the knowledge of the religion. And it doesn't only speak about fiqh that we would say ma'rifatul ahkam al-shar'iyya al-amaliyya al-muktasaba min adillatiha al-tafsiliyya as the fuqaha call it or as they define it or the usuliyin. That's not what is meant by it when we say if Allah wants good for you, He gives you fiqh of the religion, that you only know fiqh. It means you have understanding of the religion in totality, the whole of the religion, whether it be aqeedah, whether it be hadith, whether it be fiqh. You understand everything. Because the word fiqh, when the Quran uses it, it means the whole religion. Because the hadith of Jibreel, بَيْنَمَا نَحْنُ جُلُوسٌ عِنْدَ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ ذَاتَ يَوْمٍ اطَّلَعَ عَلَيْنَا رَجُلٌ شَدِيدُ بَيَاضِ الثِّيَابِ شَدِيدُ سَوَادِ الشَّعْرِ لا يرى عليه أثر السفر ولا يعرفه منا أحد حتى جلس إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فأسند ركبتيه إلى ركبتيه ووضع كفيه على فخذيه وقال يا محمد أخبرني عن الإسلام فقال الإسلام أن تشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمد رسول الله وإقام الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة وصوم رمضان وحج بيت الله الحرام قال صدقت فعجبنا له يسأله ويصدقه قال فأخبرني عن الإيمان قال الإيمان أن تؤمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله واليوم الآخر وتؤمن بالقدر خيره وشره قال فأخبرني عن الإحسان قال أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراك قال فأخبرني عن الساعة قال ما المسؤول عنها بأعلم من السائل قال فأخبرني عن أماراتها قال أن تلد الأمة ربتها وأن ترى الحفاة العراة العالة رعاء الشاء يتطاولون في البنيان ثم انطلق فلبثت مليا ثم قال يا عمر أتدري من السائل قلت الله ورسوله أعلم قال فإنه جبريل أتاكم يعلمكم دينكم This hadith teaches us that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was asked about what? He was asked about three things. He was asked about Islam, Iman, and what? Ihsan. And what did the Prophet call all of that? Atakum yu'allimukum. So he came to teach you your what? Your religion. And then the religion is not just what? Fiqh only. It encompasses aqidah, encompasses everything. So, may yuridillahu bihi khayran yufaqihu fi deen. يُعَلِّمُكُمْ دِينُكُمْ is the same. So the hadith of Jibreel is the comprehensive understanding of the whole religion. الْفَائِدَةُ السَّابِعَةُ The seventh fa'idah that we take from the hadith is أَهَمِيَةُ التَّفَقُّهُ The importance of understanding the religion, brothers. The religion, brothers, is not مُجَرَّدُ حِفْظِ الْآيَاتِ Just having mere memorization of the ayat of the Qur'an and the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is not. Rather, بَلْ هُوَ فَهْمٌ وَلِذَلِكَ عُمَرْ بْنُ الْخَطَّابِ He placed Abu Musa al-Ash'ari in charge of Iraq. And when he sent him a letter, Umar radiallahu anhu, he said to Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, الْفَهْمَ الْفَهْمُ Who said this? Umar to Abu Musa al-Ash'ari. He sent him a letter and he said to him, Al-Fahm, Al-Fahm. Try to understand the religion. Having memorized the Quran and memorized the Ahadith is not the matter. ولذلك الإمام مالك رحمه الله, what did he say? He said, ليس العلم, knowledge is not بكثرة الرواية. Knowledge is not بكثرة الرواية, who has more narrations. Rather, knowledge is what? علم يقذفه الله. It's knowledge is light. يقذفه الله, that Allah throws في قلوب عباده, in the hearts of his slaves. ولذلك أحمد بن صالح المصري من أصحاب مالك رحمه الله, is from the students of Imam Malik, who understood what Malik meant. He said that نور يقذفه الله. Malik means by this الفقه والفهم لدين الله, having understanding of the religion of Allah and comprehending what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying. ولذلك if you look at the Quran, what did Allah say? وتلك الأمثال نضربها للناس وما يعقلها إلا العالمون. أي أهل الفهم. Allah says we give parables in the Quran. وَتِلْكَ الْأَمْثَالُ نَضْرِبُهَا لِلنَّاسِ. We give examples and parables in the Quran. Allah says وَمَا يَعْقِلُهَا. No one understands it except who? إِلَّا الْعَالِمُونَ. أي أهل الفهم, the people who comprehend. Also Allah said in the Quran وَدَاوُودَ وَسُلَيْمَانَ إِذْ يَحْكُمَانِ فِي الْحَرْضِ إِذْ نَفَشَتْ فِيهِ غَنَمُ الْقَوْمِ وَكُنَّا لِحُكْمِهِمْ شَاهِدِينَ فَفَهَّمْنَاهَا سُلَيْمَانَ وَكُلًّا آتَيْنَاهُ حُكْمًا وَعِلْمًا وَكُلًّا آتَيْنَاهُ حُكْمًا وَعِلْمًا. Allah tells us that He made Sulaiman understand in this particular issue which Dawood didn't understand. So fam of the religion, understanding the deen, having what? Comprehension. أَنَا الْفَهْمُ أَنَا الْفِقْهُ is very, very vital. It's what the religion, it requires from you. ولذلك Allah says in the Quran, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ أَمْ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبٍ أَقْفَالُهَا. That you, this tells you that it's not مجرد حفظ الآيات, just having mere memorization of the words. أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ وَلَوْ كَانَ مِنْ عِنْدِ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ لَوَجَدُوا فِيهِ اخْتِلَافًا كَثِيرًا. أَفَلَمْ يَتَدَبَّرُوا الْقَوْلَ. All of those verses, what did they say? Show you that the Quran was set down for what? كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ إِلَيْكَ مُبَارَكٌ لِيَتَّبَّرُوا آيَاتِ. I need to understand it. So what is needed from you is al-fiqh wal-fahm. ولذلك the ulama, they say al-fiqh is دقيق الفهم. Fiqh doesn't just necessarily mean fahm. It's more detailed type of understanding. ولذلك you don't say السماء فهمت فقهت أن السماء فوقنا. That I've come to know about that the sky is above us. Fiqh is not used for that. Fahm, yes, not fiqh. Fiqh is دقيق الفهم. It's more detailed. It's that which comes بعد النظر, after observation, وتفكر, and thinking. So it shouldn't make you think to yourself that the matter is memorization and having mere memorization. Memorization is good. It's what's needed. But the person should work towards understanding. ولذلك الله says in the Quran, ليس المؤمنون لينفروا كافة فلولا نفر من كل فرقة منهم طائفة ليتفقهوا في الدين ولينذروا قومهم إذا رجعوا إليهم لعلهم يحذرون. That the believers shouldn't all go out to the battlefield. There should be a group that's left. What's the group that's left? Their job? Their job is to make sure that they understand the religion, so that the people who come back, they can convey the message to them and they can warn them. Al-Hasir ya ikhwa, the conclusion, my beloved brothers and sisters, is this particular hadith, عَظِيمٌ جِدَّ. This hadith is very great. And it talks about many beneficial points. We've extracted some of the benefits that are in it. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He makes this majlis, this sitting of ours, a sitting that will get us closer to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم على عبده ورسوله نبينا محمد وآله وصحبه أجمعين سبحانك اللهم بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.